Hi and welcome back to another tutorial. My name is Alex and in this quick tip tutorial I'm going to try to explain to you how you can create such high poly models for your designs. This can be used for grips, for example, or something similar. So let's get started. On the top view, under create, select a cylinder and draw it out. And under in the front view, just make something you are looking for and make sure you have this kind of look on polygon distribution. Right click on it, convert it to editable poly, and on the top view press 4 on the keyboard or go to polygon selection and select top and bottom part and delete it. The front view, press 2 on the keyboard or go to edge selection, select these edges and loop them. And under modifier list, type in twist or tap T on the keyboard a couple of times until you get to the twist and press enter. Then type in 60 or some other value that you like under angle and make sure you have Z axis selected. Right click on it, collapse tool. Now go to edge selection and select this edge and ring it and loop it. Hold Alt to this and deselect the top and bottom one, and under create selection set type in a name that you like for this selection to be saved. And now go back to vertex selection, Control A on the keyboard, and under edit vertices connect them. Go back to edge selection and now go under name selection set list and click on edges or the name that you just created and control backspace to delete it. Now we are going to select all the edges and we're going to chamfer them a little bit and then just control shift and click on polygons to get this kind of selection and shift bevel it a little bit. Make sure you don't go too far so this polygon still look right. Go out of polygon selection and I'm going to duplicate it by holding shift and click and dragging it so you can see how you can create some different designs out of this and apply Turbosmooth modifier to it to iteration isolate display, and this is the default one. And now we're going to go to Turbosmooth and two iteration isolate display and let's see if we click on smoothing groups then this happens. And if we duplicate it again and under edit poly and just grow a selection like this and apply a new polygroup selection and let's see what happens, and you get something like this. So you can see you can play around with smoothing groups settings and you get quickly some different designs. So you could also go and duplicate this and go under this and let's grow selection and hold control and click on edges and chamfer these edges one more time, this time just a little bit so we get crisp edges, and apply a Turbosmooth modifier to it and you can see you get something like this. So this was it for this tutorial. I hope you learned something new. So check out the rest of the tutorials on my YouTube channel. I have tutorials for 3ds Max, ZBrush, Photoshop and some quick tip tutorials. Subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed already, comment this video, like it, share it, and till next time. Bye.